we're doing task 20, keeping operative records. I have the patient record, the anesthesia sheet, and then the controlled drug logs where I'll log the controlled drugs that we get. So for the patient record, I have just all the history and things like that in here. And the anesthesia sheet is going to tell us what pre-medications to give and how much propofol to get up. And it's also going to leave me a spot to write down all the parameters during surgery, during the procedure. It's going to tell me exactly how many fluids to give, what the fluid rate is, and then also how old the patient is and an emergency drug range. So for atropine, glycoepinephrine, if I were to have to give a colloid bolus, all that information will be in here. Also will tell me what the oxygen flow rate should be at, what bag size I should be using. So you can see by the sheet, for a 14 kg patient who had a V slot, we have the midazolam, the mg per mil IV and what time it was given, as well as the hydro and the cefazolin. We always give cefazolin at the start of the procedure, and then propofol, the recommended dose is 5.6 mils. We usually pull up a few mils more just in case we need it. So in this case, we pulled up 8 mils of propofol and used to effect until we could intubate the patient. The controlled drug logs, so whenever the midazolam and hydro are controlled, we also keep logs for the propofol. So hydro is a class 2 drug, so it'll go in a separate book. And then we have class 3 and 4 injectable, where I'll write the midazolam. And then the propofol has its